I've got the flu. I just want to crawl into a warm pair of flannel pajamas, hide under a warm down comforter. I just want to wrap myself in warmth.
That's why there's Tylenol Cold and Flu Hot Liquid, with more medicine than any other hot liquid flu formula, plus the Tylenol name you've always trusted. So it helps relieve your flu symptoms while it wraps you in soothing warmth. Tylenol Cold and Flu. Nobody cares for your flu like Tylenol Cold and Flu.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, stay close a little longer, hold tight a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness lasts right through it. Your fresh breath goes on and on. While you chew it, say goodbye a little longer, make it last a little longer. Give your breath long-lasting freshness.
TV Guide has hidden $100,000 in somebody's Sunday newspaper. All you have to do is find it. Look for the Don't Watch TV in the Dark game in the coupon section of your Sunday paper. Then use the decoder in this issue of TV Guide to see if you've won. Now, who says there's nothing but bad news in the paper? TV Guide. Don't watch TV in the dark.
Everybody knows ghosts don't exist. Or do they? See the latest evidence and decide for yourself. Sightings, Ghosts, Friday.
Sunday, get a double hit of In Living Color and Married with Children. First, the stars join together. On an all-new episode, part of a full hour of In Living Color. Then, will poor Al Bundy strike it rich as a phony fortune teller?
Mr. Brown! Your lucky day is Wednesday.
An all-new episode kicks off a full hour of Married with Children after an hour of In Living Color on the Fox Double Hit Sunday.
With one of the highest resale values in its class and proven Honda reliability, the Accord truly is a safe place to put your money. Don't put your dreams on hold. Announcing a very special Accord lease program at participating Honda dealers.
I remember it well. I'd just come out of some of the most rugged country of Utah when I turned 200,000 miles on my truck.
I was way back in the woods. It's rugged. It's at the base of Chestnut Mountain. A lot of people won't go there, but it's a special place to me.
I pulled over to the side of the road, showed a sign saying 200,000 miles. Is that cool or what?
Where were you when your Toyota truck hit 100, 200, or 300,000 miles? Call us and tell us your story.
The only truck I'll ever own will be a Toyota. I'll tell you that much right now.
Thank you, Doctor.
I'm not a real doctor. But if I were, I'd recommend Ligament for occasional muscle pain.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
What makes you feel most female?
A thousand things.
One thing.
Silk. Definitely silk.
Sheer elegance. The luxurious look and feel of real silk in a pantyhose.
It's more than feminine.
It's like silk.
It's sensuously spirited. Magnificently female.
What makes you feel most female?
Sheer elegance. The collection.
Nothing beats a great pair of legs.
Millions of women spend billions to look their best, and then they use solid antiperspirants that can leave a messy white residue on their skin and clothing. Come on, don't mess that dress like that. Use Ban Clear, a new solid deodorant you can actually see through. Look, sometimes you don't want an antiperspirant, but you always want odor protection. And Ban Clear deodorant goes on without the messy white residue solid antiperspirants can leave. So come on, don't mess that dress. Use new Clear deodorant from Ban.
Watch out for, there's a new temptation. Stay Burrito Bell Grande. It's a steak sensation. Do a Taco Bell, it'll make your mouth water for a steak sensation. Better run for the border. Tender and juicy, every bite an obsession. With crispy potatoes, tangy sauces, bring the cheddar cheese on. Steak Burrito Bell Grande, Taco Bell temptation. Run for the border.
Not just white,
Really white.
Not just white.
Really white.
When you want whiter whites...
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
Centerfold Sherry Dunson was every man's fantasy until she became one man's target. Tomorrow night, help police solve the mystery of her murder. Watch America's Most Wanted. Then, you'll see recorded evidence that some say proves the existence of ghosts.
It's an opportunity to witness things that we've been taught all our life cannot be.
Sightings, Ghosts, a one-hour special right after America's Most Wanted.
Tonight at 11, climb in with the latest in arcade technology on The Dennis Miller Show. Now, Fox 49 presents Newsroom 6, next, only on Fox 49.
Guaranteed nail enamel. 85 colors guaranteed to be the best you've ever worn.
How does your Toyota dealer stack up? Any deal they can make better.
Can we deliver?
Yes, we can.
Great selection.
Yes, we can.
Big savings.
Yes, we can.
Great deal.
Yes, we can.
Your Toyota dealers are moving thousands of new Toyotas with immediate delivery, special financing, and the year's biggest option package savings.
Go on.
You go on.
Okay.
Say yes to the year's biggest deals.
Can we deliver?
It ends soon, so see your Toyota dealer today.
Yes, we can.
Roseanne and Tom Arnold have recently been seen on Oprah, Arsenio, and Saturday Night Live. What's left for me to ask them? Who the hell knows?
Tonight at 11 on Fox 49. This is KPDX, Fox 49, your Portland-Vancouver Fox station, broadcasting to Oregon and Southwest Washington. Live at 10 p.m., Fox 49 presents Newsroom 6.
Good evening, I'm Eric Schmidt. This morning, he ran the country's largest charity organization. Tonight, he's without a job. United Way's national president, William Armini, resigned today after local agencies questioned his hefty salary and business perks.
The United Way. It brings out the best in all of us.
During a teleconference call today, Armini announced his resignation, apologizing for traveling first class on United Way contributions. He also took a salary of almost $500,000 and a condominium from a spin-off organization. 22 years on the job, Armini expected to retire next year. He'll stay on until a search committee finds a successor. He admitted making mistakes but denied wrongdoing.
That would hurt the local United Way's, the mission, or the people we serve.
Organizers of local programs like this one in Seattle expect the scandal to hurt their fundraising efforts. In exchange for marketing assistance, they gave 1% of the money they raised to the United Way. The scandal at the National United Way outraged local charities who depend on United Way money. But as Craig Cheatham reports tonight, they hope the publicity won't hurt fundraising here.
It's a wonderful campus. It's another...
The Perry Center for Children is 125 years old.
We have a little over 11 acres, and the value...
32 emotionally disturbed children live here. Another 16 visit for daycare. Most of them are victims of abuse and in-state custody.
Many of these children just developmentally have been very delayed. You know, they're just not learning and not able to make use of a school situation until they've been here for a while.
The Perry Center gets more than $200,000 a year from the United Way of the Columbia and Willamette. If donations dry up because of the United Way scandal in Washington, it could mean fewer children will get the treatment they need.
These are not good times for finding more sources of operating income. On the other hand, everybody's trying to figure out ways to do more because there's so much need.
The Portland chapter of the United Way stopped paying membership dues to the national group when the scandal first broke.
I'm not sure that it affects us directly because, again, we're a standalone organization, and hopefully we've got everybody convinced of that.
The Portland chapter will wait until early April to decide if it will renew its ties to the United Way of America. The money from the United Way is more important than ever to small nonprofit groups fearing state and federal cuts. Ross Miller hopes the United Way's public relations nightmare doesn't become a fundraising nightmare as well. Craig Cheatham, Newsroom 6.
A California murder investigation changed course today. Detectives in Ventura County now believe Asian gangsters murdered a Japanese businessman. Police had suspected an angry American. The murdered man's son told police his father was threatened 2 weeks ago by an unemployed American who blamed Japan for his and this country's financial problems. But investigators specializing in Asian gang killings say the stab wounds resemble a hit by a Japanese organized crime syndicate. School administrators in Woodburn, Oregon say they're outraged over what they consider racist flyers. The flyers are distributed by a group calling itself the America Values Association. It stereotypes Hispanics, saying, quote, they breed faster. Administrators believe the group blames Hispanics for overcrowding.